Let's look at how bird-in-hand BIH works as a long-run fiscal benchmark. Let's look at profile of spending and saving under bird-in-hand approach. So here, we're comparing the bird-in-hand approach, that's the blue line, versus the PIH, and we also have the profile of resource revenue. We've already covered the PIH. Well, what about the BIH? Let's look at the first segment over here. During these first 10 years, government is not collecting anything from resources on the ground. So, you know, it has zero resource revenue. But BIS says you can only spend the interest you earn on your asset holdings from accumulation of financial assets. But they're not accumulating anything. As a result, any interest rate times zero, it will be zero. As a result, government is not using any of the resource revenue during this period. In contrast to PIH, government is spending something, in this case close to $4 million, because it's borrowing. BIH rules that out. He says you only pay yourself the interest as a function of your asset accumulation. So if no assets are there in the bank, government is not spending anything. And that's why the path is zero all the way. So if you follow a bird in hand, you only start consuming when you're actually getting resource revenue, and then you use some and you bank the rest in a bank or in a sovereign wealth fund, if you like. So as resources are being developed and being sold, government obviously doesn't spend all this much. This is the path of government spending. The rest is getting saved. So it's gradually ramping up spending while it's accumulating assets. And each year, it only pays itself the interest rate times the previous year's asset holdings. As a result, it knows exactly how much they're going to consume out of resource revenue. So as the assets are being built up, gradually spending ratchets it up. And then when they reach a point that they run the resource wealth down, they just pay themselves the interest on the financial assets, just like as government has done during this period. But in this case, they have accumulated large enough that interest on the financial assets becomes a constant number because the assets itself remain constant because government only takes out the interest out of the bank or out of the wealth fund. So in that case, this part acts very much like a primary income hypothesis. The only difference is that under BIH, government only spends the interest on financial assets already in the bank or a sovereign wealth fund. Here, under PIH, government pays itself interest on the present value of the financial assets in accumulated inside or outside the country, plus present value resource wealth. As a result, you can see there is a big difference between the consumption and under BIH and PIH. So you can see the BIH is very conservative. It restricts borrowing because you're only a function of your past buildup of savings, just like in a household. You cannot go out. But under PIH, because you have this constant consumption path, consumption or spending become lower than the spending under PIH. So if I look at a comparison of the asset holdings, which is this chart, you can see the implication very clearly. Under PIH, we already covered this path. You become a net borrower over here, and gradually you build up your assets, you become net creditor, and you hit the permanent income hypothesis mark. Under BIH, you're not building up anything, so you're neither borrowing or lending. And as production starts and you're saving some, gradually your asset holding starts going up until you hit this mark. And then once you pay yourself interest on those financial assets, then your net wealth remains constant at this time. So if you look at the these two benchmarks for net wealth, you can see because bird in hand is very conservative, he ends up saving a lot more than permanent income hypothesis. As a result, his financial saving or assets buildup is much higher than PIH. So if you put the two together, the picture is probably become more obvious that under PIH, you have a constant consumption path, but you spend less than under PIH. As a result, BIH has more savings than under PIH. In sum, BIH, bird in hand, is a more conservative rule. It results in less spending and more saving. BIH is fiscally sustainable, like PIH. It delinks spending from commodity price volatility, but not perhaps suitable for countries with little assets and large spending needs. BIH is practiced by Norway, which is one of the largest sovereign wealth funds in the world.